just wanna make you laugh. I just wanna see that smile. Baby, we're only here for a little while. I just wanna hold you till you fall asleep. I want love, I want us, I want you, I want me, I want peace.
Welcome back to another episode of Morning Coffee. My name is Rick Alexander. It's Friday. We have another Clarity Academy kicking off on Sunday, and this will be the last one of the year. It'll also be the last one that I run with the current format. I have some really great ideas of what I'm going to do with this program. And you know, speaking of the Clarity Academy, and so we have a couple of spots open. If you're interested, jump in on that. But speaking of the Clarity Academy, you know, one of the things that I find is a lot of people have really big intentions to change, and they start coming up against limiting beliefs, and those limiting beliefs will drive them away from the change that they're seeking. And they'll often blame it on other things. Like, I see that quite often, actually. I've done that with myself a lot, right? It's like you have all of these things that you want to do, and then the struggle becomes not empowering the voices that tell you that you can't, right? Because those voices will always exist. There's also voices telling you can, but we're never taught to empower those. And we're certainly not taught to lean on them or find them. And so that struggle is something that I'm intimately familiar with. And so yesterday I shared one of the struggles of sharing, of allowing enthusiasm to override my discernment in life. Well, one of the other things that I struggle with is not empowering the voices that say that I can do whatever it is that I'm looking to do. And one of the reasons that I struggle with that is because for the longest time, I had a really bad habit of allowing what could be to be completely ruined by what never was. See, a lot of times what never was is the thing that's driving our narratives and our thoughts in life. Like, for example, this happens, you know, you see this a lot when people, we'll use a breakup. I think that's a really good example. Or if you get fired, or really whenever the rug really gets pulled out from under you in life, right? Like you had a reality that you were headed toward. And so you've capitulated your life in that way. And that's what you picture as reality. Now, the truth is all you ever had was the moment, right? That future that you were looking at, you never actually had it, right? It wasn't actually yours. And maybe it wasn't going to serve you. And perhaps that's why you lost it. And you still can't see that, right? And so what happens is, because we didn't make the decision for things to change, we allow what never was, right? That was never ours. That moment never even happened. We allow that picture, what never was, to change what actually could be. And so now what do we have? We have another moment, right? And that's all you're ever given. You're constantly given moments until you're not. And so you're given moments over and over and over again. And you're allowing all these projections of how you think moments should unfold to block you from how they're actually unfolding right now. And so you have a hard time being happy because you didn't get the life that you thought you were slated for. The thing to understand is always that it never actually happened, and it was never guaranteed, and it was never yours. So you can't go along with your life allowing this manifested future that you had in your head, the idea of what could be, block you from what is right now. But a lot of us are doing that, right? Now, you can feel sadness for these things. You can feel immense grief for these things. You can and you should. You should allow yourself actually to feel them, because if you don't feel them, then you'll never actually get through them. But there comes a certain point where you've felt them and you've learned the lessons, right? And so now it's time to make the most of this moment, the one that you're given. That's all you ever have. Now, if you keep your focus in the moment and you understand that, you don't cling to a picture of what it could be, then you're free to experience it fully, right? It might be that somebody walking away is really hard based on the picture that you had, but it also might be somebody walking away is a really beautiful experience, but you're not open to experiencing it because you had your idea already pictured, right? You already had the idea that they were going to stay. Same thing with yourself. Perhaps you picture yourself in a job, in a certain profession, and you get in that profession, or in a certain life, right? Maybe marriage, who knows? You get in that profession, you get in that marriage, you get in that relationship, you get in that life, and you start going down it, right? And then all of a sudden you start realizing, well, shit, not all that glitters is gold, and maybe I have some different ideas for myself. Maybe it's time to pursue that thing that deep down I've always been wanting to pursue, right? And so as you have that moment, right, you know, you have to use good positive discernment like we talked about yesterday. But if you're really ready for something new, like a new career or a new job or a new hobby, then you can't let this old picture of what you thought your life was going to be like stop you from going down the path that you know is actually meant for you. That's how we allow what never was to stop us from what is. stop us from experiencing what is, right? And so then we see us leaving that job as this really tragic thing or this really sad thing, or maybe we see relationships as ending. And the reason we see it as sad is because we didn't have that pictured for ourselves, right? We had it pictured that we'd be with these people forever, or we'd be with this job forever. We'd be, you know, making a certain rank in the military or making a certain title in whatever job. Right. But there's great beauty in walking away from something, right? Because there's beauty in new beginnings. There's beauty in rebirth. There's beauty in opportunity. There's beauty in the way that you just carry yourself when you go through something really fucking difficult. But it's so hard to see that beauty if you don't ever stop clinging onto the picture of what you thought your life could have been. And so I would just urge you, just like, you know, we had an episode, I think it was a week ago or maybe it was a couple weeks ago, where it's like, you know, the past doesn't exist any longer, right? It only exists in your head, and we just keep dragging it into the future, and we're allowing it to ruin our moment. And so now what we're doing is we're taking something that doesn't exist except for in our heads, and we're squashing the moment with it. Well, we're doing the exact same thing with the future all the time. We have pictures of where we think we're going, and when that doesn't happen, all of a sudden a deviation from the path feels like it hurts, right? But the reality is it's actually a moment of great liberation, and that's what it can be. But if you don't give it the opportunity to be, then all it will be is what should have been. How easy is it to enjoy what should have been? It's just really easy to get attached to these ideas about what we could be and where we're going. And we get really excited about those things. And you start having all these high hopes. And of course, hope is one of the most important things in the entire world. And it's okay to hold on to hope, but there becomes a point where that hope doesn't actually have a opportunity to manifest. And in that moment, all you're holding on to is a picture of what was, and you're letting it ruin what is. And what is beautiful. I keep finding that over and over. As soon as I drop my judgment about how something's supposed to be, I find that thing is exactly what I need it to be. And I think you'll probably find the same thing as well. Anyway, I love you guys. I hope you have an amazing weekend, and we'll chat Monday on Morning Coffee. Inside.
stone statues trying hard not to laugh. Maybe there's something in the movement or the stillness of the air. Put that good stuff on ice and keep that elephant over there. Let's shift through modern times. I hold a future past. Non-existent obstacles squarely in our path. Absolution.